So first of all, I would like to thank organizers for inviting me here. It's really always a pleasure to be here on these conferences, which I think mostly not skip for the last 10 years. So last 2 years ago, I have devoted my talk to Vortex Berezinski Kostelitz Forest Transition and very thin films. And today, as you see again, I have on the title this family names, Berezinski Kostelitz Forest, but now it is Church, Berezinski Kostelitz Forest Transition and Superconducting Niobium Titanium Nitride Films. So first of all, it is some continuation of my many years topic studying this problem and nature of two-dimensional superconductivity and especially the systems which are very, very close to the superconductor insulator transition. First of all, I would like to thank all my collaborators through all these years and now a little bit deja vu. This is exactly a slide which was the first slide 2 years ago when I have explained what's this Berezinski Kostelitz Forest transition and thin films. So the specific of two-dimensionality is that superconducting order parameter appears not at the one temperatures, but this transition really goes like in two stages. At relatively high temperatures, superconducting order parameter appears at first. And we call it critical temperature. And only at the lower temperature, there is a transition to the true superconducting state, true in the sense of we have global phase coherence. So between them, there is a resistive state. And now I would like only to emphasize the main ingredient which involved here in this Berezinski Kostelitz Forest transition. So basically, this transition is a consequence of the logarithmic interaction between elements. No matter what we are talking about, vortices, charges, dislocations, physics everywhere the same. And the only thing, it is a logarithmic interaction with distance between the elements. I just would like to show you how this transition looks from one specific experiment. Really, this transition can be checked in many experiments from the linear resistance, non-linear resistance, magnetization, a lot of things. But here today, I will concentrate only on the resistive measurements how to determine TBKT from the linear measurements. So what we know, that basically, on approach of we have superconducting film, so the temperature already a little bit less than TC, so there is order parameter, and now on approach from the above to this vortex BKT transition, what we can observe in the experiment, if it is really measured very accurately, we can observe this critical divergent conductivity, which is expressed by this formula. And how it looks from the point of view of experiment, you can find out all this stuff here. Just example. Okay, so this is transition, and I'm, as experimentalist, I'm always very, very proud when I present results. You see double logarithmic scale on a temperature and on a resistance. So now how we can find out and how we can justify that what we observed, that really this system experienced a Berezinski Kostelitz Forest transition. So let's just play with this formula and putting the same data on these coordinates. The only adjusting parameter here, temperature. So if we take temperature a little bit larger than we have taken here, the data will go like this. If it is a little bit smaller, like this. So there is only one unique temperature. When, as you see here, almost five orders, five decades, the resistance follows this expression. So it is pretty nice, exemplary vortex BKT transition. Now, as I have said, my main focus it is close to the superconducting insulator transition, and we come 9 years ago with the idea that superconductor should have, there is a counterpart for superconductor, it is super insulator, in the sense that, okay, it's possible to have in two dimensions the state the infinite resistance will be at finite temperature. And what is distinguished, what differs this superinsulator from usual insulator? That where we know that in usual insulator it reaches zero conductivity or infinite resistance only at zero temperature. Now we would like to see this. A main gradient, two-dimensional systems. And we come with these ideas that the transition to this superinsulating state would be the same nature as a usual what we have known before, vortex Brzezinski Kosterlitz Fowler's transition. But now this transition will occur in the system of charges. This is just some paragraph from our paper. And we can come with this sketch of phase diagram. I have shown already this part, and now we are on this part. So our claim for all these years was that the superinsulating state, it is the low temperature charge BKT phase. Exactly like superconducting state, it is low temperature vortex BKT phase. Main ingredient, two-dimensionality. Okay, but for this, we of course, what do we need? We need logarithm in the interaction between charges. And in order to have this two-dimensional Coulomb interaction, which will be logarithmic, our system should be very, very close to the direct superconducting insulator transition. Indeed, what does it mean two-dimensional Coulomb interaction? We know that in thin film, two charges will interact logarithmically on a distances less than the simple approximation dielectric constant multiplied to the thickness of the film. So in order to have a reasonably large scale, special scale, we need to have a reasonably large dielectric constant in the system. And this is exact calculations, and what we see, it is, oh my God, 50 years ago. Okay, all these calculations about two logarithmic interaction, when film with dielectric constant epsilon immersed between 2 hours, exact. And what we know that, okay, up to the distances, which is called electrostatic penetration depth, really the two charges will interact logarithmically. And it is all this really very old stuff, and such anomaly that near the metal insulator transition, the electric constant goes to infinity, it was pretty nice settled, many times observed, that indeed there is such divergence of the dielectric constant, and this phenomenon was named polarization catastrophe. And again, you see what dates all these papers. So indeed, if system very, very close to the metal insulator transition, superconducting insulator transition, we can expect divergence of the dielectric constant. So it can be really extremely huge, extremely large, and electrostatic penetration depth can reach a microscopic length. So we will have, in this sense, we will have logarithmic interaction. It's just some examples from different papers on all these huge dielectric constants. Okay, and now our results. And I would like to say you that what you will see. So if somebody now is sleeping, please wake up, because of what I'm going to show you nearest 15 minutes. It is what you have never seen before, never. Okay, niobium titanium nitride films. We have investigated all structure, they are polycrystalline. In order to form, we use atomic layer deposition technique. So we know everything about this material. We investigated carefully the stoichiometric composition of this film. We know all distances. So they are polycrystalline, and it is, we know ratio. Now, we have prepared in the same conditions films with different thicknesses. So 10, 15, 20 nanometers. Here I will concentrate now on this stuff. Okay, and what we see, yes, of course, as it should be, the thinner the film, the smaller the critical temperature, and specifically for this, as you see, we even do not see a full transition in the superconducting state, so I suppose that still here, maybe if TBKT, vortex BKT exists, it should be a little bit smaller. So we somehow stuck in this bosometal state. Okay, But nevertheless, it shows immediately that this film is really in the critical region of the superconducting insulator transition. Another very important thing which I would like to emphasize here, it is that in the maximum, the resistance even larger than this miracle value, which is expected that will be separate superconducting insulating state. And we have seen it previously on the titanium nitride film. And I am really surprised why still a lot of people believe that if resistance larger than 6 kiloohms, the film should go in the insulating state. No, no, it can be superconducting. Okay, now magnetic field. I am applying magnetic field, and what I see. Okay, now for this film, 0.2 Kelvin, 200 millikelvin, one curve for this. Okay, and this is axis, resistance per square. Now let's go. A little bit larger temperature, a little bit larger. I will not put all curves in order not to crowd, but it is only for you to catch the scale in the magnetic field. So BC2 here, upper critical field, it is close to 11 Tesla. Now, what happens if I apply now magnetic field, perpendicular to the film, of course, to this critically disordered? So I have chosen approximately the same temperature region, as you see. Here, scale for this film. Now, and please note the difference in scale is 2,000. So what we see, first of all, huge, gigantic, giant peak, which occurs in the magnetic fields. There, less disordered film, still superconducting. So all this peak in the regime where superconductivity is still alive in this film. Now, please check. It is 4 Tesla maxima, specifically at this temperature. Now, let me add one more curve. Okay, all other curves also here. They are really here. Just difference in scale now a little bit larger. I have added just one curve. But now maxima, as you see, it is shifted. Let's follow the position of the maximum on this curve. So first of all, the positions, the goes. It looks like it goes to zero when the temperature will be smaller and smaller. Really, after that, we need to be fault to have a signal and to check where this maximum will be, because it is so huge. But what is important? So maxima in this magnetic resistance shifted very drastically, shifted to a zero magnetic field. So there is some mechanism, of course, if we have some non-monotonic dependence. So it means that there are two mechanisms. One mechanism which really pushes our resistance up, and another which suppresses, okay? It means that if maxima shifts to the small magnetic field, it means that the mechanism which pushes up resistance is very, very strong. Okay, now, I have put here some small rectangle, I suppose you see, because of now I'm going to show you just data in this diapason of magnetic field. And remember, the characteristic diapason for niobium titanium nitride fields, it is 11 Tesla, 11. Okay, now, temperature goes down. Okay, so at extremely small magnetic fields, which really proves that this film is really in the critical vicinity of the superconducting insulator transition, you see at magnetic fields, which is 100 times smaller than the upper critical field, the resistance almost pushes vertically. Okay, now let's have a look more carefully on all this data. I put the same here on a linear scale in temperature, and here is as Arrhenius plot. Okay. In order not to be crowded, I am proceeding here. So, certainly this temperature dependencies or the resistance, different magnetic fields, it is not Arrhenius at all. I mean, of course, you, in some small regions you can put some linear scale, but as a whole you cannot describe it. Now it is all curves together in order to see how it is. Okay, and maybe this is some kind of Avrashklovsky and some, no. No Avrashklovsky. Okay, let me do some trick. No trick at all. The matter is that now here I put the same curve, but here you see now conductance, not resistance, just one order. If it will be here resistance, I think that all of you said, okay, this is transition to the superconducting state. But please don't forget that this is now conductance. And this behavior at our magnetic field. Okay? So, what we have called superinsulator, but as I have said, is it superinsulator for us only if it is shown that it is really charged Bikini transition. Let's try to play with this very simple formula. This is the same formula which you have seen before on the superconducting side. We have only one adjusting parameter. And you see, again, the conductance follows the above equation about 5 decades. Great. Really, already in this point, I can say, guys, what you see now, you see first in your life, and so it is. That's it. But I will go further. So this is Chachev-Brzezinski-Kostolis-Fowler's transition. But we know even more about all this stuff now. Now I will forget about any kind of formulas. What I'm doing, I'm just doing some normalization. So I have chosen one temperature for each curve, which is measured at different magnetic fields. And after that, all these curves, I also will normalize at some point. I have chosen here a temperature 4 times larger than this temperature, so no fitting parameters, no any equations, nothing. What I'm doing, just normalization of all these curves, choosing only one parameter. Okay. Aha, some tail appears. Pretty nice. By the way, it is 4 means nothing, as you see, because if I choose 5, it will be the same. Okay, great. So all curves, for all curves, I have chosen just one parameter, which I call Chachev-Bikini transition, but still some tails appears. And I am sure that all of you have seen such tails. For example, opening very old reef mode of Peter Minhagen with all these calculations. By the way, Peter Minhagen in this reef mode, which is devoted to Brzezinski-Kostolis-Fowler's transition, really all mathematics presented in this on a language of Chachev-Bikini transition. It's a peculiar thing. Okay, so if electrostatic penetration length, screening length, electrostatic screening length goes to infinity, of course you will observe this behavior. But if it is finite, some tails appears. Okay, so we have pretty nice chance now even to determine the magnetic field dependence of the this screening length and correspondingly this dielectric constant, at least functionally, to know how it behaves with magnetic field. Let's play this game. So we have following exact mathematics of this review. There we understand, okay, that the resistance, conductance in our system just proportional to unbound charges, and they interact logarithmically, and after that doing self-consistently calculations, we really reproduce this expression. With all this stuff, if lambda c goes to infinity, here it will be exactly the same with how b connected to this z. Okay, and now all data which I have shown you, really, I have not put all of them here, but in all diapason up to 10. 8 Tesla, all data, as you see, pretty nice, can be described by just this usual expression for Chachev-Bikini transition. And also we have determined this lambda c, how it behaves. Okay, interesting to note that this lambda c we can, as you see here, we cannot, if it is very drastically the data goes down, we have no chance to determine lambda from this data, and only from this I have said, okay, maybe it is 700 plus minus 50, so it is rather huge error bars. But still, what we can do, we can try to estimate what kind of slope will be here and what kind of criticality or the dielectric constant in this data, from this data, we can extract. So, and what we see here, that, by the way, slope, it is 1/2. And this is exactly the slope of dielectric constant which was observed for the metal insulator transition. So all of this looks quite reasonably. Okay, and now, but all this formula where we follow these ideas of Peter Minhagen, they work only at temperatures larger than TBKT, but at temperatures below TBKT, we still observe some kind of Arrhenius tails. And peculiar thing that now, so from our analysis, we know magnetic field dependence of the charge BKT. We know the electrostatic screening length. So, and what concerns these tails, these tails can be absolutely independently checked. They follow the same logarithmic idea that they appear as only because of we have finite size effect or not. And indeed, T0, black points extracted from these slopes, goes very, very close to this theoretical expression without any coefficients. I mean, here there is no 3 divided by pi maybe, but not half, not 1/4, so it is very close. And I would like to show you these results. Classic results on a superconducting side, and this is my conclusion. So what we observe in niobium titanium nitride films, really, after many, many years of study, we are at last lucky to so pronouncedly observe this charge Березинский-Костолис-Фаулис transition, and this superinsulating state, which we have claimed 9 years ago. Thank you for your attention.